Hi everyone, this is Dr. Susan Brown, your bone health nutritionist. Today we're going to spend a few minutes just concluding our series of little videos on vitamin D, and we're going to talk about tricks and tips for getting vitamin D from sunlight. So the first thing I want to tell you is that the vast majority of our human evolution, we obtained our vitamin D through sunlight exposure. We roamed the savannas with very little clothes on. In fact, I actually worked with indigenous people like this in South America, and they were in the sunlight a great deal of the day. They developed darker skins, and they actually produced the vitamin D that they needed through sunlight. As humans, as we evolved north, left the African savannas and up into northern latitudes, we had to develop white skin because we couldn't absorb enough vitamin D because there wasn't the proper sunlight. In a second, I'm going to tell you about this issue of proper sunlight, but the whole origin of light-skinned people comes from the necessity of being able to absorb more vitamin D through the skin at northern latitudes. And actually, what happens if you don't have vitamin D, you don't absorb calcium, you develop rickets, and the pelvis is misformed, so the females could not have successful childbirth. And it was really a very important thing to get adequate vitamin D. You could see cesarean births is really related to vitamin D deficiency also, where women could not deliver babies naturally. Anyway, we evolved with a color of skin in northern latitudes that would allow more vitamin D absorption. In southern latitudes, you're really protected somewhat for the intense sunlight with a darker skin. So, we have through evolution depended on sunlight. Now we don't spend enough time in the sunlight. And if you say, well, I want to receive my vitamin D from sunlight, here's a couple tips. The first thing to remember is that not all sunlight is the same. There's only a very small spectrum of ultraviolet radiation which the body uses to produce vitamin D. And that spectrum is such that if you live any place in the United States or the Northern Hemisphere above Atlanta, you're not going to be able to produce vitamin D in much of, certainly all of the winter, even part of the fall and the spring. The trick to this is, if you're outside and you say, gee, the sun's out, I wonder if I can produce vitamin D in my skin, then you have to look at your shadow. If your shadow is shorter than you are, you can produce vitamin D with that particular spectrum of ultraviolet radiation. What that means is that the sun is sort of directly above. And I was just outside today, we're in mid-September here, and I was out about 2 o'clock. My shadow was still a little bit shorter than I was. So that means I could produce vitamin D, but by now, by 4 o'clock, I won't be able to produce vitamin D. So that's tip number one. Your shadow has to be shorter than you are. The tip number two is very interesting. So you might say, okay, I was outside, the shadow was shorter than I worked in my garden for an hour. I must be producing good vitamin D. But what scientists have now discovered, of course, we produce vitamin D in the skin from sunlight exposure, but it takes 2 days to produce that vitamin D. So the latest research suggests that if you wash with soap within 48 hours of that sunlight exposure, you're not going to be able to produce vitamin D in the skin. So that's a really interesting thing. Most of us get out in the sun, come shower with soap. So if you shower, don't use soap for a couple days if you want to depend on sunlight for your vitamin D. Vitamin D is a terrifically important nutrient. It's great to get sunlight. The authorities that we recommend maybe 20, 30 minutes a day. I personally spend much more time outside because I really like being outside in sunlight exposure. We never want to burn. But we're probably not going to get enough vitamin D from the sunlight unless you live in a really southern latitude and actually spend out time and don't shower with soap within 48 hours of getting the sun. So I hope this is useful. We're going to remember we should probably test our vitamin D. It's likely you're going to need supplements. A good place to start is 2,000 international units, which is what we put in the Better Bones Builder. Many people need much more. But you can gauge by your tests. So we'll talk later. Have a great day. See you soon.